We're supposed to have a freedom of democracy in this land. Now, where are they? The government takes them away. So fight with us. Make sure these bills do not go anywhere. Thank you very much. And that's all I have to say.
Thank you. Chief Bellegarde?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Thank Chairman. You.
All right, that is Elder Raymond Robinson. I'm going to say he's sounding off and them's fighting words. And a man who's no stranger to fighting words is the host of The Source, Ezra Levant.
I had no idea was so mad. I mean, where's Fabio since those I Can't Believe It's Not Butter ads?
Oh,
there
man.
He is. He's up there. He's still looking hunky, the beautiful, gorgeous hair. I'm joking around.
And he has a question for you. Oh. Do you have a problem with his color? Because apparently we have a problem with the finances. That's where I left the story. Right. But yeah. He wants to know if we have a problem with his color.
Well, the colors I'm interested in are green, where it's all the missing money.
Yeah.
And, of course,
from
red ink. Red ink up there in Attawapiskat. You know, I was hoping that Chief Theresa Spence would have actually been at the press conference today and actually answered questions from reporters, because there are a lot of questions. I have one, and I'm going to share it with the world, because in the hopes that maybe someone can get this question to Chief Spence, and that is, in the Deloitte audit that came out about 2 weeks ago, showing
that little thing.
Yeah, that little thing showing that of the $104 million spent in Attawapiskat over the last 5 years, 81% there's no records for it.
Mm-hmm.
But and some of that is small amounts, but some of it's enormous amounts. There were several million-dollar deals for real estate. Now, Anita, here's my point.
Yeah.
The Indian band already owns all the property on reserve. That's the thing about Indian bands. So these were not purchases on reserve, I don't think.
Where are they?
Yeah, are they buying businesses off reserve or getaways in Florida? I have no idea. But when you take money that should be going to poor people to,
And we know it's not going there because we've seen those homes. Unfortunately, many are living in squalor.
Now, I do not believe that asking accountability questions of politicians of any race is racist.
No.
In fact, I believe, Anita, that if we do not ask accountability questions of a group of politicians just because they happen to be Indian, well, that's racism. That's what we call the soft bigotry of low expectations. Oh, they're Indian, so we shouldn't ask tough accountability questions. You know what? If you take that approach, which much of the media party does, you're not going to fix the problem on Attawapiskat. And the thing is, the media, which is normally extremely skeptical with politicians, I mean, if that was a white politician giving that rambling, self-indulgent, well, and my elders and my grandpa, if that was a white politician, people would have started, reporters would have started heckling.
Absolutely.
But because he was Indian, people said, oh, shh, be very respectful. He's a holy man. No, he's not. He's a politician. The Indian Act says the word chief is what we call a mayor of a small town. But a white journalist hears chief, they say, oh, be very, very reverential. BS. Where's the money? And why is his people living in squalor?
Absolutely. Those are great questions. And again, I just want to leave it with this. Pretty strong words that Raymond Robinson was using. Pretty much, I'm going to put it out there. He is baiting us. He is saying, is there a problem with my color? No, Raymond, there's not a problem with your color. There's a problem with big mismanagement of finances at the reserve. Yeah. And we want answers. Your people want answers.
Yeah, isn't that the truth? If you care about people living in poverty in reserves, you must ask questions. And even if the chief says, oh, it's audits are racist, math is racist, press conference are racist, don't buy it. We wouldn't buy it in ad scam. We didn't buy it in the construction industry mafia in Montreal. And, you know, Italian mafia didn't say, oh, you're racist to accuse us of that. You know, French Canadians in ad scam didn't say you're racist. It is not racist to ask Indians, where did the money go?
Not at all. Where's the money? All right, Ezra, we got to leave it there. I know you always have a rock and roll show, but tonight, ever so much, boy, did they give you a lot to work with today.
I'm looking forward to it because we've got to keep asking questions, even though they won't answer.
Absolutely. And you're blowing up on Twitter there. You're asking the tough questions, and hopefully we'll get some answers soon, right?
Here's hoping.
Okay. Thanks, Ezra.
Thanks, Anita.
It's Ezra Levant, the host of The Source. You can tune into Ezra tonight at 5 p.m. Eastern. Folks, this is your Air Canada cross-country check-in.